Hi, I'm Lars, and in this video, I will compare the workflows of two AI assistants for Linux administration, Admin Companion and Red Hat Lightspeed Command Line Assistant. Both will get the same real-world task, implement rate limiting for an NGINX HTTP server. Let's go through both sessions. With the Red Hat Command Line Assistant, you get a question and answer tool into your shell. You call it with CLA, can place a question, and the answer is displayed on the shell. It is not here to execute commands, and it answers questions in a general way, which you then can apply yourself on the system. When I say in a general way, I mean it is not aware of your specific system configuration, nor is it aware of previous questions you have asked. So it bases its answer purely on the request you ask now. Here, for example, it can tell us that we have to change the NGINX configuration and that the configuration typically is in etc NGINX, nginx.conf, or in a file included by it, but it does not know really where it is. Workflow-wise, with Red Hat Lightspeed Command Line Assistant, we now need to follow this plan manually. So we need to edit the files, insert the blocks that were proposed, investigate issues and fix them by ourselves. When we now request to test the limiting, we get back a question about what limiting to be tested, processes, CPU time, network, or whatever. So the assistant is not aware anymore that we were talking about NGINX limiting before. So if we want to follow up a topic, we have to give the full context in each request again in this assistant. In our case, we tell it we want to have the NGINX rate limiting. Then we get a draft snippet that we can use to test it. Now let's have a look on the workflow with Admin Companion for the same request. We invoke the assistance with the command AI and also just append the request. It also proposes a plan, but then we see the first difference in the workflow. It asks for permission to execute a command to investigate the current NGINX configuration. If and only if we confirm it, it executes the command and analyzes its output. During this process, it makes transparent where it is reasoning, which means it's following an internal chain of thought, and where it is consulting the internal knowledge base, here for example the NGINX knowledge base. Due to that investigation, Admin Companion now exactly knows in which file and in which path the location block is and proposes a second non-changing command to show this block. Only now, as it knows the exact configuration of our system, it proposes the change exactly tailored to our system. Let's freeze the terminal at this point just to recognize that Admin Companion is telling us that it is doing a change now. It creates a backup before doing a change on the file. And after the change, it's creating a diff to see whether the change was correct. Finally, it performs a syntax check, reloads NGINX, makes sure the reload works, and asks us for confirmation. Now, as everything is implemented, it asks us for a confirmation to execute a quick burst test to see whether everything is working as expected and gives us a quick wrap-up of what it did. So what does this comparison actually show? Both tools are useful, but they are built for different kinds of interaction. The Red Hat CLA is mainly a guidance tool. You ask, it answers with strong Red Hat specific context. Admin Companion is built around execution oriented workflows. System administration is iterative, stateful, and often exploratory, so Admin Companion goes beyond suggestions. It can execute commands, interpret live output, and progress tasks step by step, while the administrator always stays in control. And that difference shows up in practice. In this run, the uncut manual session took about 8 minutes, while the admin companion session took about 2 minutes, roughly a 75% reduction for this task. That's it for this comparison. Thanks for watching.